You'll find a lot of content, both here on Nomad Capitalist and elsewhere. How to open an offshore bank account easily, with a dollar, without going anywhere, with no money, with no credit, with bad credit. But let's say you're a truly successful person and you've got a lot of money. What is the offshore banking solution for you? We're going to talk about offshore banking for wealthy people in this video. Hi, I'm Andrew Henderson, and of course, if you are a decamillionaire, an ultra high net worth individual, your needs are going to be different. And so in this video, I want to give you a couple things that we keep in mind. Obviously, there are no universal truths, but these are things that we keep in mind when we are helping folks that are in this category. It's actually been the biggest growth segment in our business is folks with $50 million and more. And so what that person is probably not going to do, they're not going to go and open a bank account at, you know, Bank of Georgia in Georgia. Not because Bank of Georgia is bad. In fact, they might open a bank account there for some other purpose. They're doing a property deal in Georgia, buying an apartment building, whatever. They might want that bank account just for some diversification, but they don't have the same needs or the same reasons to open it, right? So all these emerging world bank accounts that offer low minimums or offer some easier way to get in, don't require a bank reference letter. Those are things that if you're a wealthy person, you can provide. You have the money, you have the context, you can get your lawyer to write a letter. So you don't really need those accounts that for most people serve as just an easy way to dip their toe into the offshore world. You know, Bank of Georgia, if you have $5,000 is a much better option than going to Singapore and doing a priority bank for $200,000 if you don't have the money. So here are a couple factors that we keep in mind for the ultra high net worth individuals. Number one, I generally avoid the very staid US-Switzerland private banking paradigm. In the private banking world, in the high, you know, society of this space, those are two of the biggest players. So US banks, you know, banks like Chase have part of their bank that goes after these very successful people. Obviously, Switzerland is one of the most well-known jurisdictions in the world for banking overseas. I tend to avoid both of them for a couple of reasons. Number one, no matter how focused a U.S. bank is on higher net worth people, it's still a U.S. bank. And if there's one thing I know about U.S. banks, it's that while they do serve some purpose in some people's plans in a limited way, U.S. banks really only know the United States. They can talk about their international experience. They can talk about having people in different parts of the world. But when I call my credit card and they ask me to spell Istanbul because they've never heard of it, that tells you a lot. And I've got a credit card that's supposed to be for successful people. It's just a different experience in the US. Switzerland, on the other hand, is largely a pain. If you are a US citizen, they're probably not going to deal with you. If you're a former US citizen, they may not want to deal with you. They, in my mind, are the perfect example of the juice is not worth the squeeze. Now, I say that for someone who has, a couple million dollars, maybe they want to put $500,000 in the bank. I would say it for a lot of people who might want to put $5 million in the bank of their, $50 million. I think in Switzerland, the juice is not worth the squeeze. They're constantly giving you problems. They drag the process out. It's just an example of old school marketing that has lasted for so long. When I'm looking for anything, a place to live, a place to invest, a place to bank, I don't want to buy into the marketing hype. And the US and Switzerland are two great examples of name brands. They are the Louis Vuitton of the banking world. And I like Louis Vuitton, but let's admit what Louis Vuitton is. Louis Vuitton once made a very, very high quality product that truly wealthy people bought. And now it's a mass affluent brand. There's rumors they make the stuff in Romania and just, finish it in France. So it's a brand. US and Switzerland are brands. I don't want to buy into brands. I want to go where I can get true value. I want to find, that shoe company where they're still, hand making their shoes, in three back streets away from the Champs-Élysées, rather than the name brand. The other place that I generally avoid for that reason, if it's less of a brand, is Liechtenstein, also a pain. Now, if you are a certain type of person, let's say that you're a European and you have, 5 million francs or euros or dollars to deposit, Liechtenstein may work, but in many cases, I just find, again, it doesn't live up to the hype. I also find that they reject a lot of people. Again, US citizens, former US citizens, they're very particular, and that's fine, that works for them. But I'm not looking to fight. If I have $5 million or $10 million to deposit in one bank, and I've got banks all around the world, I don't want to fight to be accepted. I want to be warmly accepted. And the last thing I do is I'm avoiding the big international mega banks. HSBC, worst ever. Yeah, they have a private bank. I wouldn't bank there. The big US banks, you know, Chase, you know, all these, you know, big name Citi, meh. So I'm not opposed to mega banks on a local or regional level. What I am opposed to is the big international mega banks. If everyone can get an account there, then no one can get an account there. The fact that they ring fence some kind of private banking, it just, the experience just isn't as good because they're not built for that. It's like, you know, saying we're going to build a luxury car on a Ford chassis. It just doesn't really work out. So what kind of banks do I like? And what are the banks that are widely talked about as within the private banking circles as being good? In Europe, BNP Paribas, a French bank, does a very nice job. In Asia, I think Singapore is kind of the opposite of Switzerland in that it offers everything that is promised, but without the marketing hype. Obviously, Singapore is a name brand, but not one that's been overpriced, in my opinion. Bank of Singapore does a nice job. DBS, a private wealth, private client, you know, really nice service for, you know, from a million up to several million dollars in deposits. Also in Asia, KEB Hana, Korean bank, they do a nice job. If you really want Switzerland, then Credit Suisse or Pictet, some of the better ones. Personally, again, I've talked about why banking in Europe is a pain. You can watch our video on that. I think that if you look at the trajectory of wealth over the last couple of thousands of years, you've seen it start in Asia, and wealth has moved westward over to Europe as Europe and then later North America became wealthy, and now the trajectory is moving backward, back towards Asia. You see a lot more wealth being generated in Asia. You see a slower pace in some of the Western economies. And so for me, if I'm doing private banking, I'm going to look more to Asia, where the focus is still on service. The focus is still on excellence and not that name brand. You might consider some banks in the Middle East. Certainly, Lebanon is kind of the most interesting player that has some interesting private banks. I know a lot of people who are watching these videos might be rather surprised and a little bit weirded out by the idea of banking in Lebanon or even some of the private banks in, let's say, Dubai. But for me, Asia is one of the great places that we look at. We do put people in banks in the UK for, you know, £2 million. We have put people in banks in Europe. But for me, my starting point is going to be Asia. That's how we do private banking for high net worth people here at Nomad Capitalist.
Hi, I'm Andrew Henderson from Nomad Capitalist. I wrote this book, which you can find on Amazon, to distill a lot of the stuff we talk about in these videos and a lot of the stuff I've learned over the last decade plus traveling all around the world, teaching you about how to legally reduce your taxes, build your personal freedom, and create wealth faster. Definitely get a copy of this book if you want to learn more. Now, if you want to watch more videos, make sure you subscribe to our channel and make sure you click the notifications bell so you never miss one of our new videos with more tips on how to go where you're treated best. And if you're already a 6- or 7-figure entrepreneur and you'd like to put these strategies in place for yourself, go to nomadcapitalist.com and learn about how I can help you.